Hello and welcome back. Let's learn to write macros in Google Sheets. I have logged into my Gmail account. I will go here to this Google Apps, click on it, scroll down and select Sheets. Once I select Sheets, I can open an older sheet or I can select a blank sheet, which I'm going to do now. Once I select this blank sheet, like in Excel, you get this worksheet. You can change the name of this spreadsheet. You can say, for example, add one. So it has been saved to Google Drive. We'll go to Tools, and here we will select the script editor. This is something like the Visual Basic editor or Visual Basic for Applications editor. You can also record macros as you see here. So this time we will take the script editor, and once you click on it, you will be offered something like this. You can imagine that this is sub and this is the subroutine name. So you could write the code from here in between these two curly brackets. But instead of doing that, I'm just going to delete this and I'm going to paste a macro that I've created, and you can see the same structure is there, function and the curly brackets. Instead of my function, I've named this add one. There are two variables here, the cell variable, which gets us the active cell, starting with the spreadsheet app dot get active sheet. Very similar to what you see in Excel. And then we get the active cell, except here that we write a semicolon. Then the value is got from the active cell, that means get the value of the active cell and multiply that with 1. Finally, what do we do? We set the value of the cell to the value it had here earlier, plus 1. So it has effectively added 1 to the cell value. So I can save this project, but before I do that, I can click here and rename this project. So I'll call it add one and rename this. I'm going to save the project. So the project is saved and I can run it. But before I run it, let me go to my Google Sheet and let me write some value here, for example 20. Okay, I'll press enter and I'll select this cell because this is where I want the change to happen. So I go back to my script editor and click on run, just in the same manner as you do in Excel. So I click on it, you can see something is happening here, but it says authorization required. This project requires your permission to access your data. So we will say okay, review permissions. Google will ask me to log in again, so I'll click here. Google hasn't verified this app, so it says go back to safety. This can be dangerous because it is running a script. We know that we can trust the script, so we'll go to advanced and we'll go to add one. Google will also send me a message, then I'll say allow. Now please remember, in Excel you can't run macros online, especially the ones that you use via your Outlook, that is the web application that you get free from Microsoft. So we will click allow. Google has sent us a message, and at the same time it gives out a message, execution started and execution completed, right here. And we can go to our sheet and see that the value has changed to 21. We can go here and we can again run this. It says execution started, execution completed. So when we go here, we see the value 22. Now if you didn't want to go all the all the way to the script editor and then run it, you could do something that you always do in Excel. You could insert an image here, or a shape, or whatever you like, or something like a button, for example. But I'm going to go to insert and insert an image. I'm going to insert the image over cells, insert in cell, because it'll give us a small image here. So I prefer to take this image over cells. I'll browse to my image. So there it is. Open. An image has been inserted here. I can move it. I can edit it, place it properly here. And do you see these three dots? If I click on them, I get an option to assign this to a script. So I'll click on assign script, and we'll say here add one. Click on OK. So now I can use this just like in Excel. If I click on this, this should become 23. You see that? And script is finished running. So I'll click again. Look for the messages here. Done. Now there are two main advantages of using Google Sheets. One is that it is free, and second is that you can share it on the net straight away. So if you click on this, you see you can add people with whom you wish to share this worksheet, and you can also give out links to people. That means you can get a link, copy the link, and send it out to the people with whom you want to share this worksheet. I hope you found this interesting and useful. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed as yet, consider subscribing. Thanks for watching.